says you're not subbed.
What the motherfucker? Why?
If you aren't subbed, sub now. At 10k subs, I dye this fucking hair gray. Sub now! Alright, what's going on, y'all? It is your boy, Velly. Two Eyes, back with another video, and today is Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to all of my subscribers, supporters, fans, whatever you want to call it. Until I make an OnlyFans and it make me a millionaire. I don't got fans. But you already know what I'm about to say. Before we dive into this Lil Peep Part 1, fancies moving around and stuff. Oh my god. Before we dive into this reaction, you already know I have to dive into the Instagram shoutouts. Thank you guys so much for being so active on Instagram. You guys are kicking ass on Instagram and showing hella support, and I fuck with y'all for that. And yes, not many from the last video, but still many in my eyes. Must nigga, I cannot talk in the morning, guys. I'm sorry, but thank you guys. That's all I'm trying to say. But let's dive into this intro and this album reaction. Let's hope that wakes me up. I'm very excited for this. I've heard a couple of songs in this album, I believe. We will see, because you already know I got that ear. I could tell if I've heard something or not right from the beginning. So we'll see. I have an apple on my face, so I might eat it in the middle of it. I have a little snack, you know? Yeah, let's dive into the intro.
Slide, 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 slide. If you want to die off the 30, if you worthy, I might have to pipe. I'm a rocker, hit a copper if I have to pipe.
Okay, so the full project is 30 minutes. And I think I see some familiar songs that I've heard, but we will see. He say, you know it's fucked when you, when the pain feels nice, with the ice, bruh. I love the slight guitar strums with the slight piano notes. Dude, what a beautiful way to start off a project. I love this. Why is it not on Spotify? He said, smoking strong out the bar, trying to make this song. He said, I got voices in my head and they tell me call it quits. I got Xannies in my bed and they help me go back to sleep. I think that's what he said on the second line. I know for sure I got that first line right. Woo, he is saying some deep stuff, man. He is, man. Oh. I am loving this song. I'm loving the vibe already. It's a lot more rapping. And I love it. I like that. I like that. Because he keeps it a little melodic with his rapping. And you got to respect that. And I can't help but see the Schema Posse logo. And this full album reaction was uploaded 2016. So I think this came out 2015, if I'm not mistaken, though. So that's pretty cool. We're going on a time machine. Fuck you talking about? He said, I'm praying to the sky. I don't even know why. He said, no, dude, he's going crazy to start off this album. He said, I get a kick out of hitting licks. Track and he going fucking hard, yeah, yeah. Shit, it's early in the morning. Happy Thanksgiving to my fucking supporters, yeah, yeah. Praying to the sky. Dude, that was amazing. It's gonna be hard to top that song. Okay, we're in the second song, we're going already in. The way I see things. And it looks way shorter. He said, I got a feeling I ain't gonna be here from this shit. And then you got that slight in the background, and then dude, oh man, we're diving into a full project here, guys. Holy shit. Feel much pain, got a knife in my back and a bullet in my brain. Oh my gosh, you guys understand what that means? He's saying he's been stabbed in the back by his friends or a friend or something, and a bullet in his brain, meaning he wants to off himself, he wants to kill himself, he doesn't want to be here anymore. Oh man, dude, that just hit fucking home. Come said running away from me, but I'm not giving up on you. Oh my God, that can mean so many things. That can be him talking about like a friend that he doesn't want to give up on that has turned to like the dark side, you know. That could be him talking about a girl that he really likes that he just wants to go after, and he sees that she doesn't like him, so he doesn't really, you know, push forward, but he still wants to, you know. I don't know. That means a lot. I don't know. I used to have that mentality too. Like, I'm never going to give up on this person. Like, regardless if it was like a girl or like a role model that I had really young. I learned in life, like, as soon as a motherfucker gives you that fucking reason to hate them, I think you have, I don't know. It's really deep. But I've learned from like this past year, like when they give you those strikes, man, I think it's time to get the hell out and focus on you and focus on building yourself, you know? I don't fuck with the strikes, man. Like when people give you them strikes, the signs are there for a reason. Like your gut wrenches for a reason. Alright, so the next song is High School. I think I've heard this. I'm not sure. Yes, I have. And I've seen this shot on the documentary. It was like the very first shot after his dad or his grandfather's poem in the beginning. He's waiting for me. Faithfully. It's giving me chills down my spine. I love reacting to songs that you guys that I already know, like I can sing along with, just close my eyes and remember the lyrics too. Oh, I love this song so much, bro. You can feel the pain in his singing, and it's very touching. Holy man, God. I want to listen to one of these albums when I absolutely need it the most. Like, I can only imagine how connected you are to him. By you, I mean you guys. I can only imagine how connected you guys are to him, because I'm super connected to him. The tambourines, yes. I remember reacting to this because I remember saying skirt after he said that.
Kill myself, I should take some drugs, you know.
So far this album has been based a lot on depression, heartbreak, and suicide. Those are like the three topics of this album from the first three songs. So it's pretty sad, but it's fucking beautiful, as I don't even know how to describe it right now, guys. I'm still waking up. This album's actually waking me up. Another album's waking me up, guys. It's actually fucking amazing. And I can use these albums as alarm clocks. Just play the whole thing. I'll probably sleep through the whole damn thing until like the end. The Suicide Boys t-shirt.
I remember when you used to hold me close and say you love me. Ooh. Now you're acting like a ghost, and that's okay. I know I'm ugly.
Yeah, he's degrading himself this entire album so far. As to where Hellboy, it seems like towards the end of the album, he was more uplift. Well, not uplift. You, I guess you don't want to say uplifting, but I guess want to say a little more positive, even if he was kind of degrading somebody else. But on this, he's just downright degrading himself and just being super. He just called himself ugly. Like, come on, Peep, you're not ugly. You look like Justin Bieber in this pic, man. Come on. I know it was a joke when he was alive and stuff, but he literally looks like fucking Justin Bieber in this motherfucking picture. What the fuck? Like, come on, bruh.
He said, fuck the place I'm from. If it ain't about the money, please don't waste no time.
He said, if I carry on, I'ma need some marijuana, put it in a bond, and I make another song. It's fucking fire. That's just such a fire fucking saying. I got that shit off rip. Holy hell, man. This was fucking amazing, dude. He's showcasing his rap skills a lot in this thing. Like, he's, even though he's melodic throughout the whole thing, he's rapping. Like, he's rapping his ass off. Like, whoo, Drunk Velly, he'd be fucking backflipping right now. Whoo, this is so beautiful. This is like, oh, I'm happy I'm not Drunk Velly right now, dude. I'm happy I'm chill, high, morning Velly, fucking finna eat breakfast during editing this Velly. God damn it. But yes, the instrumental, don't even get me started on that. The bass drops and the constant bass line throughout the whole thing is beautiful. This picture is fucking fire, bro. I need to see this in color. Because I think I've seen other pictures of him in his day. This same day. Because I've seen other pictures of him with the same shirt, you know. Ooh, more guitar in the beginning. I fucking love it. This is 5 degrees. Have I heard this? Yeah, I've heard this. Got my name. Bro, I think I reacted to this, but I haven't heard it since. Definitely haven't heard it since. A lot of these songs I haven't heard since because it's so many songs I've reacted to. I have to literally go back and look at what songs I've reacted to because I'd be so scared to see like a song or hear a song that I haven't heard on the channel yet. But in this case, this is definitely on the channel somewhere. It's somewhere, dude, because I remember hearing this. Oh, it sounds so good. You hear like the bass in the back, like and then he said, I got my name from my mama. I mean, I technically got my name from my granddad because he was like the first person to call me Velly, like as a kid. Like he was the only person to call me Velly, like as a kid, like when I was little. So I guess I could say the same thing about my granddad. So hey, GP, I know you're watching probably.
Wanna go to hell, but I wanna kill myself tonight.
Thank you.
I don't wanna die, I'm gone tonight. I don't wanna go to hell, but I'm gonna kill myself tonight.
This is nothing to you. I used to dream of you. It's like a lose-lose in this situation. He said, I used to dream of you, and I used to lose sleep because of you. Like, goddamn, you're in my dreams, and you're the reason I'm not dreaming. Jeez, man. These songs are hitting deep. I'm just gonna pause this real quick. I'm so happy I'm listening to new music from him, or in my case, new music from him, because I've just been spamming Hellboy and like all my other music, just spamming fucking Hellboy, guys. Like, I feel like I know every song, goddamn near. I love that goddamn album, bruh. I've been spamming that shit. Like, I haven't had nothing else to goddamn play, so. Now I'm going to be spamming this because this shit is fucking. This boy has not missed. This shit is fire, bruh. Man, he's coming with these beautiful melodic hooks, but he's coming with these melodic, very lyrical verses, man. Like, you have to give him credit on that. He's writing these songs very good. And he structuring them very fucking phenomenal. You have to give him credit for that. Man, this shit is... This shit's hitting hard. Now, I can relate to that more than anything. I've been doing my own thing lately. I've been holding my own self for safety. Psh. Hey, let me tell you something, man. For you guys, I have been doing that just as much. I have been focusing on myself, my mental health, my health overall, so I can, be consistent as possible on YouTube and eventually make this my job, because that's my plan, and thanks to you guys, I can possibly do so. So I love you guys so much. Thank you so freaking much. Happy Thanksgiving again. I hope you guys are eating well.
Hey, ask me how I feel, I say it's crazy. She wanna come over, I said maybe later. I said maybe.
Okay, so this song, I've heard this. Have I? Oh, I think I've heard this on like the documentary. Like, I've only heard like the beginning. It's like, and then it faded off. I think it was on the documentary or somebody's mini documentary on YouTube or something, but I've heard like the beginning of this because I've definitely heard that.
Mm-hmm.
I let you down again.
I've heard this. This wasn't on the documentary. Hell no, I've heard this. Where did I hear this, guys? Please don't tell me this was on the stream. The infamous drunk stream. Oh my god, dude. Whenever I'm drunk, I'm gonna start wearing the slashed headband, dude, to imply that I'm drunk. Because this is getting fucking ridiculous, dude. He said, it won't feel right to get somebody else up in my bed. Dude, that is so relatable, dude. I'm losing my mind here in both ways, like reacting to the song again and knowing some lyrics. God damn it, bro. This shit is fucking crazy. I'm about to fucking go away, bro. I'm about to walk away, dude. You never hear him go high like that. I just wanna let you know I'm gonna go away today, I swear. That's featuring Velly, by the way. That's my remix. Cause I know, God knows them ain't the lyrics. We know them ain't the fucking lyrics. Bitch, I think I did react to this. Guys, you guys have to tell me if I reacted to this, because I remember saying little bit. Dude, where did I hear this? It had to have been on the stream, or I don't know. Help, guys. And you know it's me today. So I'll do anything for you.
When you deposit on DraftKings at Casino Queen Sportsbook, you can get a bonus up to $1,000. But what are you going to do with all that cash? Throw it on a lock? How about a 5-team parlay?
I think it's because Ghost Boy is one of the only songs that are monetized. I'm very excited to hear this song. This is like a party song, bruh. This is definitely a party song. A party peep song, bruh. He said, leave me alone, leave me alone. I am coming, bitch. And then, no, 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 no. Oh my god, whatever those are sounds fucking beautiful. I'm trying to think of what the fuck it is, but. Oh, man. Give me sometimes I'll be flying, bitch. I ain't gonna do it for you, I'm gonna do it for me, cause it helped me forget. I ain't gonna do it for you, I'm gonna do it for me, cause I'm trying to get away. Listen to peep. I ain't gonna do it for you, I'ma do it for me. Listen to him. And I think he's about to say, cause I wanna get rich. Yeah, do it for yourself, guys. I understand we are good people, but you have to focus on yourself to be successful, okay? You can't focus on impressing other people, even though I kind of focus on impressing you guys.
Ooh, man, when you hear that skirt, Peep is about to rap. That dude, he is just proving to us, man, that he is just, he can rap, man. Like, I am so happy y'all showed me this. I don't know, to me, this is like one of his best melodic fucking anything I've ever heard. Like, all of, like, the whole album, like, this is like... But then again, you have these fucking verses where he's really rapping and telling you stuff, man. And he's coming with these rhyme schemes that are absolutely insane to me. Oh my. Whew. Let's just continue on. So we're getting to the end of this album, and it seems like he's like, the girl's trying to get his attention, and he's like, and that's so ironic to me. Peep is strong, man. People need to realize that, man. That guy was strong, man, and he was very talented and versatile as I held myself back, guys. I didn't curse, guys. Holy sh! Dude. That outro was just phenomenal. I did not expect that beat drop at all. And I especially, dude, Lavelle, you have to get your words right, man. What is going on today, dude? Especially when you hear that. I was about to freestyle over that motherfucker. I ain't gonna lie. Then I heard him. I'm like, nah. All right, the next song is Veins. Have I heard Veins? All right. I think I heard Veins on the Notorious Drunk stream. Because that's the only way to explain how I know the... Because my drunk ass probably... Oh, shit, that fucking shit's... Oh my god, that shit sounds amazing! Where did he sample that? Oh, drunk as fuck, man. Holy shit. I knocked out a lot of fucking early songs from Peep and Tracy, I see. Because I had similar problems with a lot of early Tracy songs, dude. I'm never doing that shit again! Maybe on New Year's. I love how the beat is just looped on some classic hip-hop shit. This is like some classic hip-hop shit, and he's writing that motherfucker melodically. I love it. Oh, I heard that. He said, it's something in the butt, man, I need a new plug. All right, so in this song, it sounds like the girl is ignoring him now. Like, what the hell is going on? I thought we were leaning towards the more, like, Pete being, like, the playboy and she being, like, trying to get his attention. Now it's back to, like, where we started. He said, all my bitches dumb cause they give me all they brains.
Watch out for
mask in the back if you trying to get your ass beat. Gotta hide that identity, especially with the tattoos and the hair. Yeah. Come on. Put on the mask, creep. Come on, put on the mask. Beat his ass. He said, my flow go perfect with a sad beat. These are so quotable. He said, all I ever see is snow in the summertime. Pussy make me happy. Dude, a lot of these lines in this song are very catchy, dude.
Motherfucker, see how real it is. I want to spread so much love, you know, it's like, man, I got a lot of love to spread, and I just want the world, you feel me, I want the world to hear, you know, so it's like, I'm trying.
Got me talking about my clothes, girl, I feel it in my veins, going super hard, man, I'm going off the brain, feel it in my brain, yeah. Featuring Belly, bro, that's like five? I'm giving y'all five features today, bro. That's a mixtape. That's an EP, bro. Oh my god. That sounds like the... That sounds like, no offense to midgets or dwarfs, whatever you want to call them. But that sounds like when they throw one of them in the water and then they do the bloop, like the little effect. Oh, come on, guys. What's going on, guys? Come on, guys. Not the dwarves, man. No. Not the dwarves, man. They didn't do nothing to nobody. All right. This song's called Wannabe, bro.
Damn, son. Ooh. Where'd you find this?
Damn. I was expecting to hear some piano shit. I kinda hear it. He said the head's so fire and make you fall back cry. Do you know how good some head has to be for you to be there? While crying? I said stop! Hardy. I can't curse, guys. I can't. Woo! He said, one day I'll be over you. I had to make sure he said the head so far, because if I would have just made that joke and looked that fucking stupid and he didn't say what I thought he said, holy shit, I would have sat here and just stared at the camera for like 10 hours. I was going to say seconds, no, hours. I can be anything. Okay, this is the last song, and I'm kind of sad because I was really enjoying this goddamn ride. But this song is titled Shame on You. So, I love the Amy Winehouse picture in the background. Let's hear this outro. I'm very excited to see how this album wraps up. So far, this thing, I'm really loving this thing, man. What if life comes after death? Woo, that sounds like a band. It sounds like a band playing. Ooh, that sounds good. Hold on. I'm out here like fucking Harry Potter in this bitch. Fucking casting spells in this motherfucker. Said, what if life comes after death? Grab my knife and nail myself. This is hitting hard, bro. Ooh, and that kick is like a heartbeat, bro. Where did you go this time? I want to hear what he said. The last words were in my life, in my fucking life. I'm in my fucking life, and I don't even know why. I just want to die, and I be lying. Fuck, I fucked up the last line, but. Man, that album or mixtape. God damn it. I just gotta go to the... I'm on Streamlabs recording this. I'm just gonna go to this fucking screen and zoom in. But yeah, that album was very touching. I don't know if it's better than Hellboy yet. I have to listen to both of them as a whole. But from what I can tell, this had no misses at all. Hellboy... I feel like that song with SpongeBob on it. I don't know. It was Kerb LaGoop, I think that's his name. That song's good. But like that verse, like there's no misses on this song. On this album. And no features. Like that shit's amazing. And it's his debut project, dude. And he's like explaining like how he got his name and shit. Like his first heartbreak. Dude, I love this shit, man. Woo! Thank you guys so much for requesting this album out of all albums for Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to you guys. This has been a long video. I have a lot to edit, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. If you guys haven't liked the video, please make sure to like it. It really helps get the video out to more Peep fans and helps the Shitter Net gang grow. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. If you're new, it has been your boy Velly. To why?